In Forza Horizon 5, there are lots of good cars that everyone uses, but there's also some good cars that almost no one ever uses. So I've put together this video of the top 5 most underrated cars in Forza Horizon 5. Let's get into it. So we kick things off with the Ford GT40 Mark II from 1966. This car is quite underrated for A-class dirt racing. It has lots of grip and gets brilliant drive out of the corner. So on the tracks with lots of corners and not too many long straights in between, it is very good, and it's rare to see anyone else using it. Admittedly, it's not up to the same standards as the meta cars for A-class dirt racing, but at the right tracks, it's really good. Moving on to the number 4 spot, we have the Apollo Intensa Emozione Welcome Pack Edition. This thing is underrated for S2 class road racing. It is very grippy, as you might expect. So through the corners, it is absolutely planted. Not many people use this because at all of the tracks which suit the Apollo, the Brabham BT62 and Hot Wheels Bad to the Blade are better. But even though the Apollo isn't quite as good as them, it is still a very usable car for online racing. Now we move on to the number 3 spot, which is filled by the Honda NSX-R from 1992, which is underrated in S1 class dirt racing. Its straight line speed is quite good, and it is also quite good in the corners, even though it suffers a bit from understeer. The main car that overshadows this thing is the Hot Wheels Bone Shaker, but no one likes using that, so this is a very good alternative, which more people should use. Next, we have the Chopin 962R in the number 2 spot. The Chopin is underrated for S1 class road racing, because cars like the Ford GT and Jaguar XJ15 very much overshadow it. While the Chopin isn't ever the best for any specific track, it's a very good all-rounder, so at any track it will be decent, because it is quite good through the corners, and in a straight line it's not too bad either. That said, when you turn into a corner, initially you get good turning, but then it starts to understeer mid-corner, so it's important to get familiar with it first. And no, that's not caused by an overly stiff front anti-roll bar, that's just how it handles. This car is unfortunately only available with the Hot Wheels expansion though, so just keep that in mind. Finally, for the most underrated car, it's the Lotus Elise Series 1 Sport 190, which is super underrated for A-class road racing. It is my favourite car to use for online racing because it is so lightweight and nimble, so you can really chuck it into the corners and it sticks. It is not very good in a straight line, but at the tight, twisty tracks, it's quite possibly the best A-class car. Using this online will get you some wins, and more importantly, you'll have lots of fun using it. But anyway, that's it for this video. If there's any cars you think I should have included, let me know in the comments, and of course, be sure to smash the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video.